Chicken Nuggets, it's me, Carl. Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV. Hosted by Carl. Where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome to Grow TV.
Look who decided to show up. It's about time. You know, I've been waiting for you since last week. Seriously, y'all did the big idea last week and just headed out. Not me, though. I was so excited to dive into another episode, I haven't slept. No, seriously, come on, let's go. Let's go. Why isn't it working? Come on, work, Bible, work. What in the world? What's happening? Ah, I'm so frustrated. I grab the Bible, I open it, I begin to read, and then I get sucked into the story. Oh, why isn't it not happening? Every other time it worked. Oh, I got it. Maybe there's a phrase I have to say for it to work the third time. Let's try it. Skiddly-doo, skiddly-dang. Take me inside this Bible story thing. Huh. Maybe there's a type of dance I have to do. No, that ain't working either. Come on, what's taking so long? Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take three long, deep breaths, then I'm gonna open the Bible and slowly start reading. Then, and hopefully then, I'll be able to be back in the story like last time. Here we go. Whoa, here we are. Wow. Mate, feels good to be back. Wonder what made the difference. Grace!
Carl, how are you, buddy?
I'm great, now.
Why do you say that?
Well, you wouldn't believe how long it took for me to get back here.
Really?
Really? I mean, I've been waiting around here since last week, restless. Well, then I tried to hurry up and get back once my friend showed up, but it took a few tries.
Well, what worked?
Well, I had to take a few deep breaths, take my time. I guess I had to be a little, what's the word?
Patient?
Yes, patient. How'd you know that?
Well, Carl, I think patience is the reason we are here today.
Really? Why's that?
You see that tree behind you?
Sure I do.
Well, that tree is our focus for today's story.
Hold up, you're telling me that tree is what we're talking about today? A tree? Some weird little cherry tree is what I'm here for? What kind of story is this? I have more important things to do than talk about a tree, okay?
Carl, first off, you need to calm down. Deep breaths, okay? Feel better?
Yeah.
Okay, secondly, it's not a cherry tree, it's a fig tree. And well, the story you opened up to, Carl, in Luke chapter 13, it's not a very common story. But don't let that fool you. It's very important.
All right, I'm listening.
You see, Jesus was telling us a parable. It was about a man who owned a vineyard, which is land with fruit plants and trees on it.
Okay, I'm following you.
So the man went to check and see if there was any fruit on the tree, and guess what?
The tree was actually an alien robot sent to destroy all other vegetables.
No, the man saw it had no fruit, and he got kind of frustrated. So he turned to the person in charge of taking care of the trees and said, "For 3 years now, I've been coming to look for fruit on this fig tree and haven't found any. Cut it down. Why should it use up the soil?"
Whoa, he was going to cut them down because they didn't have fruit?
Yep. But the person looked back at the owner of the vineyard and said to wait one more year.
Wait, really? I hate waiting.
We know, Carl. But the person said they would take extra care of the tree in the next year, and then they would see if it bore fruit. If it did, then great. But if the tree didn't bear fruit, then they would cut it down.
Wait, that doesn't make sense. Why wait a whole year? Well, if it's a bad tree, I say, cut it down.
Well, you have a point. But can I ask you a question, Carl?
Fine, but make it quick. I've always wanted to cut down a tree.
Do you ever make mistakes?
Yeah. Who doesn't?
Here's another question. If God sees you messing up and making mistakes, would you want God to be patient with you?
Yeah. I would hope so.
Well, that's exactly what's happening here with the fig tree.
Huh?
Yeah. You see, this is just a story Jesus was telling, a parable. And it was a way of teaching us to show how patient God is with us.
So in this case, we're the tree?
Exactly. And just like trees, we were created with a purpose. And that purpose is...
Leave people alone?
No, to bear fruit. Once we accept and choose to live for Jesus, God's love will automatically start flowing through us. And that's what bearing fruit is.
Oh, that makes sense. Kind of like when trees get sunlight and water, they can grow and bear fruit. But fruit don't grow on trees right away. So I guess Jesus' story is telling us that even when we're not bearing fruit, God waits for us and gives us time to keep trying?
Exactly. But we could never do it without God's help. We have to remember that. Just like that gardener was going to take care of the tree and give it time to grow, God is patient with us too.
Wow, I never thought that being compared to a tree would be a good thing. What's up, tree?
Well, hello there. And it's so good to see your faces today. Now, today's big idea is God is patient while we grow. Now, I thought it would be fun to do the big idea in a fun but patient way, okay? So instead of counting down from three, let's practice patience by starting from, I don't know, at 50? Okay, here we go. 50, 49, 48, 47, 46,
33, 32, 31, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 3, 2, 1. God is patient while we grow. Yay! Whew. All right, great job, kids, and thanks for being so patient. Now, I hope to see every single one of you next week on our next episode of Grow TV. Okay, bye, kids.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of Grow TV.
Oh, Memory Verse Challenge!
Aw, yes, a Memory Verse Challenge! Woo woo!
2 Thessalonians 3, verse 3. But the Lord is faithful, and He will strengthen you and protect you from the evil one.